share with you a fundamental, I should say, thought for the Shabbat. And by the way, not just for Shabbat, but for life. And I explain. In Parashat Kedoshim, which is the second parashat that we read this week, because we have two, Acharimot and Kedoshim, in Pasuk Yudchet, Divine Providence, Chai, 18th Pasuk, in chapter 19, the Pasuk says, Vahavta l'reacha kamocha ani Hashem. Love your fellow as yourself, I am God. Obviously, this reminds us the importance of the mitzvah of Ahavat Yisrael, to the point that we find two statements in terms of the fundamentally important aspect of Ahavat Yisrael. First one from Rabbi Akiva, where Rabbi Akiva says, Vahavta l'reacha kamocha, ze klal gadol b'torah, loving your fellow Jew, is a fundamental principle in the entire Torah. Then we find the story with Hillel HaZaken, where the individual who came to convert to Judaism with the demand on standing on one foot, and he wants to learn the whole Torah on one foot, and Hillel says, indeed, what you don't want to be done to you, don't do to the other. This is the entire Torah. The rest of Torah is commentary on it. So the Gemara tells us in the Gemara Shabbat. So two concepts. Fundamental principle or the entire Torah. Now what is it? So really these two concepts represent two different approaches and dimensions in our relationship with Torah. What comes first? When God created the world, did first come Torah and then the neshama, then the soul, then the Jewish people? Or did first come the Jewish people and then the Torah? And here again we see two opinions. Sounds Jewish. In the Medrash Rabbah, the Medrash Rabbah quotes on the name of Rav Huna and Rav Yirmiya and the name of Rabbi Yitzchak. There it says, Machshavton shel Yisrael kadma l'chol davar. The thought of creating the Jewish community, B'nai Israel, preceded everything and everyone, even before Torah. We also know, as Alter Rebbe explains in Tanya, the soul of a Jew is chelek elokam imal mamash, an integral part of God Himself. Obviously, there can be nothing before God. But then we find in the Zohar another very common expression, Israel. That we attach ourselves, we connect to Hashem, we become one with Hashem, and we are one with Torah. So we see over here a kind of a relationship, which is the world, the relationship that we have with Hashem is through Torah. In other words, when the soul comes down into this earthly world, it is through Torah. So is it before Torah or after Torah? So here is the following explanation. These two dimensions of the Jewish soul and its relationship with the Torah are reflected in the teachings of Rabbi Akiva and Hillel, as we said earlier. At its core, the basis of our love for a fellow Jew is the inherent unity of the Jewish people due to our common godly source. A source so high that indeed it is transcending the Torah. And therefore Hillel said that love for your fellow Jew is the entire Torah, because the purpose of Torah is all to connect and to become one with Hashem, to cultivate and reveal our essential connection to God. And this is best achieved through love for one another, because the love is even above Torah. It transcends Torah. Rabbi Akiva, however, he speaks of the mitzvah, the love of one of fellow Jew, as it is applied and observed practically in this world. Our connection with God is through the observance of Torah. And therefore, Rabbi Akiva couldn't say that this mitzvah is the entire Torah, but it is a fundamental principle in the entire Torah. And therefore, as he said, loving your fellow Jew is a principle, fundamental principle in the Torah, but at the same time may not override the observance of the rest of the Torah. So either way, it is fundamental, it is an integral part of Torah, and it's what connects us to Hashem. As we know, the destruction of the temple, second temple, and the reason for our exile is, as the Gemara tells us, because of the lack of love. So my friends, in this Shabbat, where we're going to talk about Acharei and Kedoshim, we're going to read about the Lariach HaKomocha, let us strengthen ourselves in that unconditional, gratuitous love for every single Jew, and indeed, we will be completely connected to Hashem by the revelation of Mashiach and finding ourselves in the Beit HaMikdash. Shabbat Shalom.